Concealed behind the aluminum walls of the Prospan are two rubber piston cups, one mounted to the bottom of the piston, the other atop the air inlet casting at the base of the Prospan. The shoring controller receives its source pressure from either an onboard air compressor, commonly found on most utility trucks, or from bottled air. Once activated, the controller sends this pressure to the Prospan. As pressure builds within the Prospan, the piston cups create an air seal, which forces the piston outwards and into contact with the wall of the trench. Once contact is made, pressure continues to build, which in turn causes the soil to compact in all directions. It's this soil compaction that holds the trench wall in place, thus preventing cave-in. This is referred to by soil engineers as the arch effect. Once the piston is finished expanding, the outer collar of the Prospan is rotated until the piston hole that is closest to the collar is exposed. The tethered steel pin is inserted through this hole, and then the outer collar is rotated until it firmly engages the steel pin. Once this has been accomplished, the air is vented from the Prospan at the controller. The result is a fixed mechanical shoring device, no longer requiring an internal pressure to do its job. Workers must surround themselves with this arch of protection. It's for this reason that shoring is installed in columns, two minimum. The worker must remain within the shored columns at all times. Additional requirements can be found in Prospan's tabulated data. Tabulated data is a mandatory component of the excavation standard.